Ronnie, the floor is lava. What are you doing?
Looks like you've been having a field day in here.
Don't tell me you've never done this.
What are you pestering me for?
Well, if you're not gonna leave, we might as well play a game.
Don't give me any attitude, Sonny.
I'm not giving you any attitude. I'm just saying you're standing in fire.
It's over.
Well, yeah, because you're pretty much burnt up now from... Wait, does that mean that you're leaving? Are you leaving? Ronnie! Are you leaving? I'm in the lava! I've made a good bit of progress on the castle, but it's kind of sporadic. It's not like my vault build where each video I had built up and completely decorated one section. With this, I've been working on various parts to see how it will all go together. And so down here, I've kind of built up a little bit of the marketplace. There's still so much that I have to do. But I just want to give you guys an idea. So, like, this one is nearly done. I still have a few more decorations and lighting to do. But this is going to be my clothing merchant, I think. Because back here, I have this ridiculous fitting room. And I laugh every time I come back here. Because I never thought I would be building a fitting room in Fallout. But it's, I don't know, I thought it was hilarious. So I just incorporated that. But a lot of the marketplace is going to be similar to that, where the shop is right there on the edge of the path. So over here is a better example of that. The shop itself is pretty narrow, and the counter comes right up next to the walkway, and that's how it's going to be through this entire area. But I haven't done much down here. This was just me testing it out to see how it all looked. One of the main things I wanted to show you in this video is the bar that I made. So this is the monorail bar. You get it? Because it's like the third rail from goodness. You get it. It's fine. But yeah, so I found this monorail in the creation kit, and I thought it was like really, really cool to use as something. I was going to have it as a walkway, but then I just kind of plopped it down right here and figured, okay, I can make a bar out of this. You know, I've been really struggling trying to figure out how to do this raider build. Like, what would raiders have in here? So I went around all the different areas to see what Bethesda did, which most of the raider settlements in the Commonwealth is just shit. There's just trash everywhere and nothing's put together. So when you go to Nuka World, it's slightly different. You get a little taste of civilization, but it's still very messy and just garbage all over the place. So that's what I'm going with. And this bar is a good example of it. I made it look lived in, but very trashy, and built up, but just the bare minimum. You know, nothing too fancy. Which, you know, it's been a lot of fun because I've never really built or decorated like this. I've always done builds for myself or the Minutemen, which are usually built up and pretty nice. But here, I made this counter by putting cinder blocks on seat cushions and plywood on top of the cinder blocks, which is now my bar. And the same thing on this side, I just put smaller counters up against the seats and then cinder blocks and plywood on the back to make it a bigger counter. Basically what I'm getting at is my decorations in this build are going to be completely different, or at least I'm going to try to make them completely different from everything else I've done. Oh, and this side, I don't know what I'm going to do over here. I think I'm going to put a patio or something. I don't know. Something like that is going to look really cool. I just got to figure it out. Oh, and the doors on the back actually work. Why would that be interesting? I will say this, if you're having a hard time decorating a raider build, throw in stuff like this. I saw this a lot in Nuka World where they have these random areas with boxes and barrels and like a table or a chair with a tarp over it. And I didn't really like these parts at first because there was no reason for them to be there. It's not like a shop or something like that. It's just a random area. But you know, I think that's the point. I'm just so used to having a reason for everything that I'm building. I changed the walkways up here a little bit. I don't know if you guys remember, but the boards went from side to side where there were no gaps. I put in these middle beams and threw down some floors and roofs on top of them to make it look like they just threw it all together instead of having the floors actually built into the frames. I don't know, it looks a little bit more unstable, and that's exactly what I was going for. The last part I want to show you is the power plant. Now, the goal with this building was to make it look as crappy as possible, but still functional. And I think it worked out. I haven't finished decorating the inside or done much of the decorating at all, but you kind of get the idea of what I'm going for. So it's very, well, it's going to be very run down and scrappy looking with a bunch of workbenches and tools and just areas that make it look like they're working on these power generators. Out here, I have this fire escape that leads down to where the water facility is going to be. And I say water facility, but really it's just going to be a couple of shacks with water pumps around it. I might add some guard posts around there or something just to keep it a little more secure, but it's not going to be anything over the top. So we got four floors in this area. Each one is pretty much the same. I mean, we have like very compact walkways with openings where I'm gonna throw in like a bunch of workbenches and stuff like that. But my main goal was to make sure that they could get to each generator, and that way if something goes wrong or whatever, they can come in here and fix it. Not to mention, everything is connected. You know me, I like having multiple ways to get around, so that's what I did in this second part. The third floor is very similar. You just have better access to the generator since they're just right here. I don't have any connecting walkways, but I do have these really cool ladders. I like the ladders. And finally, the fourth floor is probably my favorite because we got a bunch of these tarps. I just like the way that they look. But this is way more open, as you can see, so I'm gonna have a lot of workbenches and machines over here to make it look like they're sorting out the power and just distributing it from up here, like the recruitment beacon and conduits and stuff like that. Now, I'm fully aware that this structure is a bit of an eyesore by itself. You know, it's just this big rectangular building. I'm gonna add in some guard towers off to the sides, and I think that's gonna help make it not look so massive. But looking at it from the inside, right now it doesn't look too out of place, and I think it's because of these wires. I didn't like the gaps between each of these buildings. It was like, big box here, little thing here, another thing there. It didn't really flow together. But I added in these wires in the creation kit, which I think helped make them look more connected because they literally are connected. I don't know, I'm probably just tooting my own horn again, but I think it's gonna look even better whenever I add in the guard posts off to the sides. So the Fallout 76 beta is supposed to be releasing on October 23rd, which gives me 3 weeks to finish this build, and I'm pretty sure that I can do it. I just wanna have everything done and to have this mod released on all platforms before the beta comes out, because I know that whole week I'm gonna be live streaming and making videos on it. I plan on using some of the ideas you guys have given me, so when I show those areas in my video, I'll be sure to give you all a shout out. And speaking of which, let me know in the comments what you guys think I should put in for each side of the castle. Should these parts be guard posts or chill spots, or what do you think? Let me know, and if I use your suggestion, I'll give you a shout out. But thanks for watching. I recently updated my Patreon to include more tiers and rewards, so be sure to check it out for more content from me and to get the inside scoop of what I'm working on. I also updated my merch shop with a ton of new designs that I'm really excited for. I'm starting to focus way more on my Patreon and merch shop, so I really hope you guys enjoy it.